And Andrew Ritter, number 96, set to kick it away for Ole Miss.
And Ole Miss, Craig, remembers the way Javier Arenas started the game out last week against Kentucky. A 60-yard return to open the game and put his team in position to get an early score and take control of that football game.
Arenas averages nearly 30 yards a return, settles underneath at the 6-yard line. We're underway in Oxford. Arenas makes a little high step at the 20 and is swarmed down at the 25-yard line. Shotgun formation for Alabama, third down and long, call it 6. McElroy, good protection, takes a pop, drops it out to Ingram, knocked down at the 31-yard line, short of the first down. P.J. Fitzgerald inside his own 20-yard line, high snap, handles it well, the kick is away in a beauty. Green underneath, he's going to take it at the 27, finds the seam, 40, 45, and near midfield is Green. Ole Miss will have fine field position. Corey Reamer with the special teams tackle. Baxter split shotgun as Snead drops back. There's the blitz across the middle. Intercepted at the 35-yard line. Justin Woodle, the free safety, with his second interception of the season. And Steve, there's the mistake we talked about. Shotgun, McElroy. On second down and 10. Quick drop, wants to tuck and run, and there's nothing there. Driven back at the 30. A loss of 3, and that brings up third down and long.
And that allowed Greg Hardy to get in there and make the first hit, and about four or five more of his mates coming to help out.
First two games, 3 sacks for Ole Miss's D. Last 2, 8. They throw to Jones. We've had a quiet season thus far and pushes his way to the 42-yard line. And Steve, how about going above the line?
If they can show up and make Alabama in these second and third and long situations, they'll be in control of this game.
Fitzgerald, trick play, throws on fourth down and move the chains to the 49-yard line. Trickery coming from Nick Saban.
Greg McElroy out of the backfield.
Fresh downs, first and 10 from the 49, and breaking through is Ingram. Powerful, speed, 5'10", 212-pound sophomore. Seventh play of this drive, 8 minutes to play in the quarter, third down and 3. McElroy, quick drop, that ball is batted down and out of bounds, and that brings up fourth down. 3 wide receivers top of your screen for Ole Miss on third down and 10. Sneed gets pressure. And that pressure forced him to throw that ball out in front of Brandon Bolden. Eric Anders, the Jack linebacker, putting the heat. Ole Miss has not gained a yard, Steve, on 6 offensive plays. Shotgun, McElroy. Sets up and throws, arches it up and in. He loves the tight end. Colin Peake, who played at Georgia Tech, grabs his 15th catch of the year. Bama, by the way, 0 for 3. Here in this quarter on third down, McElroy from the shotgun. Little pitch and catch to the flat, and another stick driven down is Green on Ingram. And what a study he was. Hand off. There's a broken tackle by Ingram. And pulls his way past the 30 down to the 25-yard line. And for the first time today, let's go back to New York for an update. Seventh play of this drive coming up. McElroy talking to his tailback. On second down, hand off Trent Richardson, the fine freshman, lowers his pads and drives past the 20-yard line up to around the 17. Marche Green making the initial hit. Third down and 2. McElroy wants to pass, has time, up top he goes! That ball is caught and bounds, yes! First down at the 3-yard line, and again for the second time, Colin Peake, 6'6". What a target at tight end.
He has really established himself as a great player.
Long back, Richardson. Play action. There's that timing pass up top. Tight end had it, and out of his hands is Colin Peake.
Colin Peake got his feet a little bit tangled up before he jumped, and it just threw him off a little bit. He's still got to make that play.
25-yard field goal attempt by Lee Tiffin. And it's through the uprights. Tiffin now 10 of 12 this season. From 25, Alabama gets 3 on the drive. And see that field goal, the first quarter points allowed since the Cotton Bowl win against Texas Tech. Jesse Grandy, number 10, stumbles, finds a hole to the 44-yard line. And Jevon Snead, Steve, got to settle down. Confidence is one thing he needs. They're going to go to the ground with Bolden. Finds a seam, turns the corner, takes a pop and out of bounds at the 48-yard line. In motion goes Marquise Summers. After a pickup of 8, it's second down and 2 and nothing doing. Bama stands up. Corey Reamer led the charge.
All right, you got one of these third and long situations. Again, we've seen McElroy be very patient, dumping off to one of the backs. They convert third downs a lot of different ways.
Ole Miss shows blitz. They back off as McElroy from the shotgun. Pedals back. Good protection. Throws underneath. And the grab is made by Jones. And hugs that sideline. Another first down. They move the chains up to the 35-yard line. And Kendrick Lewis, the free safety, bumped him out.
And Ole Miss better wake up offensively, or this defense is not going to be able to hold up all day.
First down from the 34-yard line. Under center, McElroy now sets his feet. Throws near sideline. And a nice catch on the dig route. Julio Jones making his presence felt. In less than 4 minutes for Ole Miss. A little delay. Here comes Ingram. Lowers the pads. He does not hesitate. He's the hammer, Steve. And you're the nail. He likes to throw the hammer down.
And his punter punts the ball into the end zone. P.J. Fitzgerald, I guarantee you, does not want to get anywhere near Nick Saban right now, because that ends up being a 20-yard net punt. That's not what Nick Saban wanted.
Snead, under center, rolls, throws, caught at the 32, Jay Hodge.
Jay Hodge had 122 yards receiving last week against Vanderbilt. These two need to start making some plays.
They had a career-high 8 receptions and 2 touchdowns. And this will try the ground, and no turn of the corner. Cordero Eason, number 25, hunted down, and a loss of at least 4 back to the 30-yard line. In motion, the tight end is Harris. Draw, nothing doing. And thrown down with an attitude is Bolden by the middle linebacker, Rolando McClain.
This game is not going the way he wants it to go, but I'll tell you, he's feeling pretty darn lucky. It's only 3-0 right now.
McElroy, the quarterback. Great play action. They throw near sideline. That's Mays, number 4, wrapped up and then reached out, got an extra yard at the 47-yard line. Marche Green, the left corner, with the tackle. Southlake, Texas is home for McElroy. 3 of 8 on third downs. Pressure. That ball is thrown out of bounds. And Ole Miss's defense is keeping the Rebels in this ballgame. Marcus Tillman. 8:32 on the first half clock. Shotgun to Snead. Throws it up over the top. And a catch of the 25, Jay Hodge. Did he lose it? Yes, he did. Alabama. Javier Arenas. They've been on the field nearly 16 minutes of this first half.
And so far today, they've risen to the challenge, but it just can't happen all day long, especially when they're giving the ball deep in their territory.
McElroy under pressure, throws it across the middle. Richardson, the freshman, makes a move, picks up 8 inside the 20 to the 17-yard line. Alan Walker, strong side backer with the tackle. Under 8 to play in the second quarter. Under center is McElroy. Up and fancy, handoff Richardson. And again, slips and slides for 5. Jonathan Cornell, the middle linebacker, with the tackle.
Greg McElroy knows more about playing quarterback. He's got to hold that free safety if he wants to make that throw.
Play clock down to 2. They just get the snap away. McElroy in the pocket, flushed away. Has room to run. Chased from behind. Oh, he took a lick inside the 5 at the 4-yard line. Short of the first down.
Those land sharks, when they see a quarterback running with the football, they are coming. They are trying to get a piece of the action, man.
That's blood in the water. Oh. Tiffin hit a 25-yarder in the first quarter. This will be from 21 yards, right hash mark, and it's up and good. And I would, Steve, it's no-brainer. That's a victory for the Ole Miss defense.
No doubt about it. They got to do something to keep this crowd into it. The fans are trying hard to get excited, but just not a lot of good happening yet.
Tiffin teed up at the 30-yard line. Angles it to the far side of the field. That's Jesse Grandy. He'll bring it out. 10. Makes a move. Stutter steps. Drop to the 11-yard line. I see a flag back at the 32.
During the return, holding number 14 of the receiving team. half the distance to the goal, first down.
I'd love to see Ken Austin. I think he will show confidence in Jevin Snead, but he's got to make a good decision and a good throw.
High snap, pedals back into his own end zone, rushes out, throws, and that one's up off the hands of McCluster, who so far in this game has not been a factor. Arena sets up midfield, got a hand up on it, taking it to five.
You could see it coming.
Yep, you called it.
You could see it coming off the right side of Ole Miss's punt formation. There was an overload, and never had a chance.
Third down, crowd behind Ole Miss. Pressure is on over the top. Thrown out of bounds. Fourth down. Tiffin will try a 22-yard field goal. That ball is up and once again good. So Tiffin, three field goals of 25, 21, and 22. Great point. 0-5 on third down conversions. Third down and 10. Snead sideline and through the hands of Pat Patterson, the freshman out of Macon, Mississippi.
I'm going to find a way to get the ball in the end zone from middle of the field. Let's make a big play.
Ingram past midfield, knocked out at the 46-yard line. Tyrone Nix, the defensive coordinator, fresh legs up front now on that offense or that defensive line. It will toss out to Peak, the tight end.
Greg McElroy.
And they're going to count that ball complete.
We're going to get a fourth down, go for it here for Alabama.
One for one today, pitch. Here comes Ingram. Turns it corner. Can you say goodbye? Touchdown, Alabama.
Right now, they're just content to run the clock out and get back in the locker room and regroup.
The cluster right up the middle. And he'll push the pile.
Number 22.
And that's going to end the first half. Frustrating first half on the offensive end for Ole Miss. They played some tough defense. Bama with the 16-point lead as we go to the locker room.
They just need to have a couple good things happen. One or two good plays, all of a sudden guys start believing again.
Snead, push that ball in traffic. Hodge, and this crowd finally has something to applaud about.
That's exactly right.
Rebels have yet to convert on a third down. 0 for 6, big play. Snead in traffic, throws it away. Coverage play. Nothing downfield. And now a flag comes out, roughing.
Intentional grounding. I think number four, offense.
Was he throwing to Nick Saban?
Fourth down.
In my opinion, he should sit one more week, but I kind of doubt it's going to happen.
McElroy back to pass, throws a dart over the middle and complete. Colin Peak. It's been rough and rugged from the start for Jevin Snead. Second down, 10, shotgun. Steps up, throws wide open on the far side, and McCluster with open space picks up a first down at the 47-yard line. Back in 2005, four seasons ago. On second down, shotgun again as Snead runs out of trouble. Now tucks and runs at the 50, 45, 40, and Snead brings his crowd to their feet. First and 10 at the 36-yard line. Summers, the man in motion, swinging out to the flat, wide open, big yards. Bolden at the 20, high hurdles to the 20. Call that the 17-yard line. Superman flying high. Gerald's the center back in after missing the one play. Quarterback keeper, and Snead able to keep his balance. And pick up a couple to the seven.
You got to take a chance, I think, in this situation.
25-yard attempt by Joshua Sheen and points on the board for Ole Miss.
You never know what's out there for you, what the future holds. Seize the moment. Get after these guys and understand how lucky you are to be where you're at.
Arenas, room, 30, 35, hits the edge, flag is down. Arenas driven down at the 40, call it the 39-yard line, but hold on. Flag back at the 34.
Brady Ford, receiving team, 10-yard penalty, spotted the foul, first half.
And this defense, which stepped up all first half, the whole first half. Let's see if they've still got any gas left in the tank.
Good leg comes to the near side as Mays makes the catch and tackled at the 34-yard line. McElroy sidesteps pressure, runs out of the pocket. On his back foot, throws. Incomplete.
That was the one mistake they made. They did pay the price. Other than that, they've played at a very high level all day.
Fitzgerald. McCluster lets it bounce, picks it up. 26. At the 40. Quick as a whip. To the 42-yard line. Ball is out. Bama pointing. They've got it.
Uh-oh.
And McCluster is still down.
Boy, that was an incredible play by Corey Reamer. I don't know if you saw that play, but the way that he ripped that ball out while making the very aggressive tackle was amazing.
Ingram. The play action. Pressure. Ho-ho. Alabama just one of their last eight on third down conversion. Shotgun is McElroy. Good protection. Throws a dart. Caught. Looks to be short at the 32.
Drop everybody back in the coverage. Don't give up a big lane like that.
Bama's got to hurry. Play clock to one. They're going for it. And first down. First down from the 28. Ingram cuts it back up the middle, breaks one tackle, breaks another, has room, 10, 5, Ingram to the 3-yard line.
Julio Jones right there.
Third down and goal. And coverage up top, no. Fourth down.
It's almost predictable what they're going to do in that situation. At least you have a chance for it at that point.
And Tiffin trying for the fourth field goal of the day. This from 21 yards. And it splits the uprights. Tiffin from 21. I would agree. You got a quarter plus a minute 12 remaining. Tiffin the kick. Angles it to the far side. It's Bolden. And around the 10 opening. Oh, that ball is out! So a minute 3 to play third quarter. Back comes Ole Miss. Jevon Snead in the shotgun at the 42-yard line. Good field position for the Rebels. They set up the bubble screen. Oh. Here comes Bolden. A lot of room. 50, 45. Puts his pads down and is knocked out of bounds at the 39-yard line. In the seam, right on the money is Summers. And all of a sudden, Ole Miss moving the ball. Ole Miss 0 for 8 on third down conversion.
Here they come.
Here. Here comes Bama in the pocket. Snead up top.
Got a flag.
There's contact and a flag at the 10.
Here comes the blitz off the edge again by Alabama.
Low snap. Snead tries to thread the needle. Picked off. Jackson running room. 30, 40. Jackson 50. Jackson 40. Jackson at the 30. And knocked out of bounds at the 20-yard line. 79-yard return, Alabama. First and 10 at the 16-yard line. Oh, that ball is out. And new life for Ole Miss.
How about this Ole Miss defense?
McCluster is back in after being shaken up, number 22, and that's who Snead goes to. You need money, you go to the bank. Second down at 10 as we roll up on 13 minutes left to play. Two-step drop, little dump down, that ball is out and in the hands. Is that McClain? What a strange game. McClain, that ball popped out. McClain, right place, right time. Justin Dow, the motion man, spinning for a couple of yards as Ingram. Pass of 15, they'll mark him at the 14-yard line. From the far hash mark. Kick is away and good from 31.
The field goal is good from 32.
Snead throws it out to the flat. It's caught. Holding down the sideline, bumped out where they push him out.
Jevon
at the
Snead
31.
Oh, he hit Jevon Snead and then put every single one of his pounds on top of him.
Second down at 10. Holding. A little hide. He was hiding sneak behind Snead. Third down and 13. 0 for 8 on third down conversions. Two-step drop. Tucks. Here comes Snead. Still on his feet. Makes another nice cut. Upended at the 37 by Kareem Jackson. In motion goes Lionel Breaux. Shotgun rolling out of Snead. Pressured, throws, caught at the 45, and Bro Kevin keeps Ole Miss breathing.
There's a lot more to playing quarterback than just the physical part of it.
They throw it back to Bolden. Rumbling room, 40-yard line, 30, 35, 30. High steps it to the 20. Way to go, Mr. Gerald. Snead in trouble, throws. And again, Washington bringing pressure. And Snead, there's a flag down, tried to plead his case. And they're going to pick it up. He's gone basically nearly exclusively from the shotgun. He'll go again, shotgun. There's the pressure, sidesteps, now decides to tuck and run. 30, 25, at the 20, Snead with room, and is chopped down. Great run again at the 15-yard line. And Javier Arenas with the tackle. Under 6 minutes to play here in Oxford. The center goes McElroy again, the ball carrier. Couple yards for Ingram. In motion, Preston Dial. Steps it out to Ingram. Finds the hole, breaks the tackle. Strength, power to the 44. This continues to pound it.
Number
trying
three,
to fill the
Chuck
gap.
With the football.
Understand, by the way, Eli will be a game time decision. He's been battling with that plantar fasciitis. You ever had that problem in your day?
Number 22, Mark.
40 seconds on the fourth quarter clock. Bama just going to run this game out. Crimson Tide, Steve, going to run their record as 6-0 on the
number
season.
3-0
in the SEC West. And next week, it's the old ball coach, South Carolina, taking on Nick Saban and the Alabama Crimson Tide.
Yes, sir. It's the SEC. Every week's a big one. This right here for Nick Saban and his troops. So control of the SEC West established today.
6-0, 3-0 on the West, while Houston Nutt and Ole Miss will drop down to 3-2 and 1-2 in the SEC West. For Steve Berline, Craig Bullerjack, we say so long from Oxford with a final score, Alabama 22 and Ole Miss 3.